company as a tech lead there, and he's got a lot of knowledge with this stuff. Behzod, correct? And today he's going to be speaking about unit testing of WordPress plugins. So that's going to be a great technical talk here. But it's just an introduction, he said. So please give a warm welcome to Behzod.
Written a unit test before using PHP, stays consistent. And after you write your test, there will be another code that runs your code and checks if the result is correct. You can, for example, you can have a function that adds two numbers and returns the sum of those two numbers. So you can write another code that runs that function with different arguments. You can test two and two and verify if the result is 4. You can pass minus 2 and 2 and verify if the result is 0. And that way you ensure that your function is working correctly. And also, with that test, you will have a safety net for the future changes. So you can easily change your code and be more confident that you didn't break up something, because if you run the test and you will see that your function is working as it used to work before. Let's go through the benefits of unit testing. So it allows you to test in more granular level than just point-and-click testing in the UI or browser. So let's say you have a plugin and you did some changes, and how you test it, like first, like easiest thing is just going to the UI and clicking the button and see if you see some, if the screen changes and you see the unexpected result. You cannot test everything with just a point-and-click testing. So there might be some function that rarely will be executed, and etc. So with unit testing, you will be able to run every piece of your code and make sure it works after you change something. And with that, you will improve your code quality. So you will have better quality with that. And, you can see it in you can see those unit tests in code bases of some well-known WordPress plugins like Jetpack or Behzod. So if you go to their code bases, you can see those all unit tests. That's one of the methods they do. One of the things they do to ensure that their plugin works with different versions of PHP, with different versions of WordPress, so they test it automatically using the unit test and other automated tests too. So you already know from my previous notes that the factoring becomes more easy. You can easily change your code, and you will be confident that you didn't break something if your tests are covering like most of your code. And you can easily change your class names, you can change your method names, and run your test suite and see if it didn't break. It allows you to debug faster. So if something goes wrong, tests show you what went wrong, in which function, in which line, what was expected, what instead the function returned, or what happened instead of the expected like behavior. So it allows you to debug faster. And tests also can provide some documentation. So you can read tests and see part of the code or some functionality in the code behaves, how it's expected to behave, and that way you can learn the functionality of the plugin. And also, tests can be used to design your code. So before writing any code, you can start writing a test for it. You can start the test by I want to have a class with this name Zoom development, and this is one of the methods any large companies practice. So, so this is another benefit of having writing unit tests. So we saw all these benefits. So what do you need to do to start doing this? For starting to write unit tests, you will need a Unix-based operating system. It can be Linux or macOS. You need PHP, of course. You will need MySQL or MariaDB. You will need PHP unit testing library, WordPress test suite, which is a library of additional library of WordPress that allows you to write additional gives you additional functionality to PHP unit. WP-CLI is optional because you can write the code yourself or you can scaffold to generate the code using WP-CLI. So what if you use Windows? You cannot write the unit test. Sometimes presenters who like talk about unit testing, they like recommend to like install all these tools one by one. Install PHP, install PHP unit. You can go to their website, follow the instructions, and install each of them. This can be very overwhelming for someone new, and for someone who recently started development but wants to improve. So you have to go through and setting, configuring these tools correctly takes some time to. So I recommend for starting to use BBB. Yeah, it's very vagrant vagrants on the forums. It's a open source vagrant configuration. You can just go to their website, learn more. This is the recommended development environment for the WordPress core development too. You can go to make WordPress org and see it. And so it comes with all those tools. So it's a virtual machine. That means you can run it in Windows too. So if you use Windows, that's not a problem. Linux or Unix-based system will be running as a virtual machine in your system, and you still can run those tests inside it. So it comes with Ubuntu. You will have WordPress developed version, a stable, latest stable of the stable version of WordPress, WP-CLI. So anyway, all the tools you will need to start writing unit tests will be available. You don't need it just for running unit tests. You can run your all local environment, all your websites inside BBB. You can migrate. I would recommend you, if you want to advance your skills, I would recommend to migrate to it from things like MAMP or LAMP if you still use that. So this gives you more flexibility. It's a little bit manual. There will be a little bit manual configuration, but the configuration is a YAML file. It's very easy, and documentation is really good on the website. So you can run your local environment of all your websites in. Let's see how we can scaffold the plugin and unit tests using WP-CLI. So WP-CLI is available inside BBB, already installed. You can just SSH into the vagrant box, go to the default WordPress install with BBB, the folder of the default WordPress, it's the latest stable version of WordPress. Then you can run a command WP scaffold plugin and your plugin's name. And it will generate an empty plugin with a bunch of files inside the plugins folder. And you can cd to that folder and see the content of things it generated. So what did it create? It created a bunch of files, most of them are configurations, you can see some PHP files, but XML file, which holds the configuration information about the test suite. And the bootstrap PHP, which bootstraps your testing environment and includes the your plugins code to that. Let's go through them one by one. So PHPUnit.xml file. The important part of this is that bootstrap line, which is pointing to that bootstrap PHP file, you see. So that serves like an autoload PHP of Composer. So it will load your file for tests. And most important part is this directory part. So for the test suite part, it will here you define where your tests are. So tests are inside the tests directory, and all the tests start, well, test files start with test-prefix and ends with .php suffix. So that means when you run PHPUnit, it will search for files that start with test dash and end with .php inside the test folder and runs test inside those files. So you don't have to change this one. It's already created by WP-CLI. And the next thing is bootstrap.php. So as I mentioned, it bootstraps WordPress testing environment, then loads your plugin inside of this test environment. So you see, it's trying to find the WP tests their environment variable, and if it finds it, then if it cannot find it, then it tries to find it in the TMP folder. If it cannot find it there too, then it fails with an error message. And if it finds, then it is the next part of the file. Then include requires the file called functions.php inside the test suite directory. And then loads your plugin and then runs the bootstrap PHP file inside the WordPress test suite. So you don't have to download the test suite to it. It's already inside BBB. It's already downloaded. It will be downloaded when you run first Blender app.
If you wanted to use another virtual system like a Docker,
Not a Docker, but I'll show you how. So, can I ask for questions after the... because probably you will hear answers to your questions during the slides. Thank you. So you don't have to change this part. It's already configured everything. When you run the PHPUnit, according to the configuration, it finds this file, loads it. Next thing is quick information about those environment variables. If you try to echo those variables inside UV, you will see where they are. So this is where the first test variable is inside this folder in Lagrange box. You can go there and see how the WordPress test suite looks like. What kind of files are there? And the next thing is WP Core there. You didn't see it inside that file, but it's inside the WordPress test suite. And this variable defines where the WordPress core is for the WordPress core that you use for your unit tests. So you can test your plugin with different versions of WordPress. So in this case, the WordPress core is the latest developed version of WordPress. So when you run this test, if you run the tests for this plugin, now it will use the latest development version of WordPress inside your BBB box for when you run your tests. Another file, the third file that we mentioned that it is important is the install wp-tests.sh for shell script. This script downloads the required WordPress installs WordPress tests, it defines those environment variables, creates a database for running integration tests, and you don't have to run it inside VVVP. So if you don't use VVVP, if you have your build server or other server or another environment system, migrant environment or not migrant environment, or even Docker, you can use this script to create a testing environment for your plugin, for your code. So I'll not go through what's inside this. This is what it does, and you can use it with, you can see this usage command. So you run it, you give it the database name, database user, test, host name, and the WordPress version. Then it downloads that version of WordPress, creates a database for it, and prepares a testing environment using that version of WordPress. This is a very important script, and you can use it for running your unit tests in your build server. So when you, if you attended the presentation by Carl yesterday about continuous integration, so this is the script that must be used inside of Travis CI, GitLab CI, build servers. So you don't have to run it on your log. So, since we have everything now, we can run PHPUnit. So, you can, after scaffolding your plugin, just you go to your plugins folder inside the UV and just type PHPUnit and hit it. And you see, it returns green, okay, and it's saying that it ran one test and one assertion. So, where is that one test came from? That's this one, test-sample.php. It was generated by WP-CLI, also it's just a sample test for you to see how the PHP unit tests work. And you don't have to keep it, you can delete it, but that's how your test files will look like. So, as you see, it's a class called sample test, and it's extending a WP unit test case class. This WP test unit test case class is part of WordPress testing suite, and it extends the core test case class of PHPUnit. So it gets functionality from PHPUnit and adds some additional functionality needed for testing WordPress tests inside it. So some of those functionalities, like you can, are very useful for integration tests. For example, you can quickly generate new post, new taxonomy tour, new some WordPress related item, like it's called factories. You can easily create users, login user, try to run something in some other user, etc. So WordPress tests should inherit from this class. Now what's test? Test is methods inside this that class you create, and those methods must be named with the prefix test. PHPUnit considers all public methods of class that's prefix test as a test, and it runs them when you execute. But you don't have to name them as starting with test. In that case, if you don't want to start the name of the functions with test, you can add a add test line in the doc log, and it will consider that function as a test. to start writing a unit test, we need the code to start. We need some code to test, of course, right? If we can follow, of course, TDD, like start writing a unit test before writing this code, but we are not doing it for this presentation, it will be really hard for the introduction to understand. So let's say you have a code, like a very simple class called calculator, which has two methods, add and subtract. Add has two numbers, subtract, just add, subtract those two numbers. And you can create a class inside your filing folder and like name this class dash calculator.php. Once you have this class, you should of course require it inside your main PHP file, main plugin file, which will be executed by WordPress. Now you are ready to start writing text. So if you remember from PHP unit XML file configuration, your tests are located. It expects that tests are located inside the tests folder. So you just create your PHP files or tests inside the tests folder, or change your PHP unit configuration file. So you can always change the configuration file, but we decided not to change it, just use the default configuration. You can always put your tests in any folder you want, but change the configuration. So now configuration must be in the tests folder, and you can start writing. You can just copy and paste the sample test file and just rename it, or just type all this code as sample code here. So what you need to name the class. You can name with anything. Like I prefer to start name with test to show that this class is the test class. And so it has this one test tag. So, as you notice, it's starting with test, it means that I don't have to use that doc log. But I prefer adding a C doc logs. This allows you to quickly just comment click on this code in your IDE, and it takes you to that method you're testing. So, you can quickly switch in your code and see your test. So let's see what it's doing. It's initializing the calculator class, it's creating an object of the class, and then writing an assertion. So we are sending two and two to the add method and asserting the return value is equal to 4. It will be 4, right? So once you have this code, you can run with your PHP unit again. Go to the folder on PHP unit and it executes as expected. It returns green, all tests. Now you should see that there are two tests and two assertions. One is that dummy assertion that tests if the true is equal to true. Then the second one is we just wrote. It checks if the add method, if you pass two and two to the add method, is returning 4 and it's equal to 4 and it's passing. So let's try to fail. So we started with 4 and returned green. So if you want to test how or see how it looks like when the test fails, you can change this expected value to 5, and 2 plus 2 is not 5, of course. And after changing 5, you run your PHP unit again. Now it returns this red color and shows failures. And exactly shows where it failed. It says test calculator test get test failed, and it failed asserting that 4 matched expected 5. It's even showing the returned value of the code you wrote.